Hey, I wanted to talk about the Volvo 670. That's the truck that I owned, that I bought from Long Mountain. Had it for 5 years, paid it off back in August of last year. In my previous video, I made a snarky remark about them not knowing all of a sudden how to work on their truck. And I was being kind of funny, but I wanted to make it clear that I loved the Volvo truck. It's a very good, quiet running, smooth, expensive truck. Just pretty much like all of them. But the problem that I ran into it that I was referring to was the injector problem with the 2014 and the 2015. Once they started developing problems, right around 300,000 miles is what I've been reading online is the norm. Evidently, coming out of the factory, they used some kind of a sealant on the cups, and the design for the pressure from the injectors onto the cups is flawed. I guess that's the best way to say it. But the problem is, when you take it in to get fixed, if it's not under warranty, then, and when they replace them, they're not using the sealant anymore. They're just placing the cups in there, and it doesn't work. But that's, from according to the mechanics I talked to, that's all they're allowed to do, according to Volvo. That allows them to do that only. They can't put any kind of a sealant on it. If you double up on the cups, or you use the sealant, which I can't remember what the name of it was, it will help last a little bit longer. But because of that intense pressure and the design flaw, you're replacing your injectors every 8 months to 18 months, depending on just, you know, what's going on with your truck. And that leads to other problems. But the injectors aren't working right, you're going to develop other problems on the motor, especially as the motor gets older. So that was one of the reasons I decided I either had to buy a new truck, buy a used truck, which I had, or get out. And when you threw in a bunch of the other stuff like low rates, my health wasn't the best, and didn't seem to be getting any better with that kind of a lifestyle. Just a lot of little reasons added up, I decided to get out. But the Volvo is a good truck. It's a good company. I really can't say anything about the older Volvos, but the newer ones, I'm afraid to even get in one because I would, you know, fall in love with it. They're that nice. The living conditions are even better than ever. And so I just wanted to make that clear. The Volvo is a good truck, but the 2014-15 does have that injector problem. You can read it online yourselves. Volvo won't admit it, understandably so. I guess they don't have to. And they kind of just like have moved on type mentality. But every time I went into a Volvo dealer, I got seen pretty quick. I know there's some horror stories out there. The mechanics are always, if you ask them any questions, they talk your ears off. You know, they love to talk about their job, and they're good at it. They are. I never had anything other than the towards the end when I got a leak fixed that was still leaking, but I could bring it back in. They're going to refix it, but that's more downtime. But yeah, so I would buy another one. Especially the newer ones, you get the 5-year warranty now, and you get the platinum warranty. It's like bumper to bumper, which I highly recommend, a platinum warranty. The last thing I wanted to say was, between the time I bought my truck and now, though, they've gone up about 30% in price. so that was a big factor too. If I buy a new truck, not only do I have a truck payment now, but it's higher than it was before, even with my trade-in. It's going, you know, and that's not the direction you want to go. And low rates, it's a recipe for disaster. I didn't know about the coronavirus, so I lucked out on that, but that would have probably killed me. I probably wouldn't be able to sell the truck, because I don't think Ritchie Brothers have been able to get rid of any trucks since then. I haven't really checked, but I can imagine nobody's buying any trucks if they don't know when they're going to open up again, you know. So now coronavirus is also a game changer, so maybe truck prices will come down. Maybe rates will go up, but from what I'm hearing, they're not, which doesn't make any sense. But anyway, that's that. So in my next video, I'm going to talk about Lone Mountain. And anybody who's thinking about Lone Mountain or wants to know more about it, leave some comments, ask some questions. I'll be able to answer them for you. I'll be glad to. And hopefully get you on the right track. I got some pretty good things to say about Lone Mountain too, and you just got to be careful like anything else. So, all right, I'll talk to you later.